Hi and welcome. In this video, I will discuss certain attacks on domain name system or DNS. So let's start. Now once you open up a web browser in your laptop and write facebook.com in the URL of web browser, then the page of facebook.com appears in your laptop. And now this page is hosted on a remote location at a web server. So how does that happen? Now this process involves the translation of the facebook.com into the IP address, since your computer can only understand the location of the web page based upon the IP address. And this is done by using the domain name system. So this facebook.com is the fully qualified domain name, or FQDN. So this FQDN is resolved into its IP address in order to find the web page which is hosted on a remote location. And then the routing is performed to locate that IP address to bring or to fetch the web page of facebook.com. Now in order to find an IP address of an FQDN, the laptop first look into the local record or the DNS cache. So if you write this command on your Windows laptop, that ipconfig/display DNS, then you can find certain mappings of FQDNs and their IP addresses. Moreover, the host file on Windows laptop on this path which is shown on the screen, you can see this host file and you can manually enter the IP address of certain FQDNs. So if the IP address of an FQDN is not found in these both locations, then your network adapter settings has configured an IP address of a domain name in your laptop. So based upon the IP address of your domain name, you then access the domain name to get the IP address of FQDN. Moreover, your local DHCP server, which may be running as a service on your local router, also provides you with the IP address of DNS server. So this DNS server contains the IP address of your FQDN. So you get the IP address of this DNS server from your DHCP server or from your network card settings. And then you approach this DNS server to get the IP address of FQDN or our domain, just like facebook.com. So you send a request or a query to this DNS server on port UDP 53, and this UDP 53 is the port on DNS server in order to get queries from certain clients which wants to get the IP address of any FQDN. So this DNS server contains certain zone files. So a zone file contains the record or the IP addresses or the mapping between FQDNs or the domains and their IP addresses. So based upon the data of this zone file, this DNS server provides a client, in this case our laptop, with the IP address of facebook.com. And then you can access the web page or the website of facebook.com, which is located remotely on the internet. So based upon the IP address you got from the DNS server, you perform routing through number of routers and firewalls in order to get the or to fetch the web page which is hosted on a remote server. Now there are certain attacks which are involved or which can be performed all the components which are involved in this entire process. So an attacker can insert false data into a zone file, for example facebook.com fqdn can be mapped to a false IP address. So your laptop will then be redirected to a false web IP address or a false website instead of actual facebook.com. Or an attacker can also corrupt your local cache or the DNS cache, and an attacker can also corrupt the DNS IP set in your network card, or he can also corrupt the data of a zone file. So the DNS, in this case the DNS server will provide you with the false IP address of facebook.com, and then you will be redirected to a false website which is set up by the attacker for phishing purposes. Or an attacker can also corrupt the DNS or the DHCP setting, which may indicate a false IP address of a DNS server. So instead of actual DNS server, you will approach the wrong DNS server based upon the false IP address of your DNS of your DHCP settings. Another method is that the attacker may set up a rogue DNS server. So once you will send a query to an actual DNS server, then this rogue DNS server will monitor such queries, and it will respond before the actual DNS server will respond, and it will respond with a false IP address of a rogue website. So once the response reaches before the actual response from the actual DNS server, then this entries are registered on the client, and this session is terminated. So once the actual response from the real DNS server reaches to the client, then the client discard this response being out of session. So then the client will approach the rogue website which is set up by the attacker for phishing purposes. So this is also known as DNS farming, because the attacker has formed a rogue website for phishing purposes to get the credentials of the client. Now another attack is the domain hijacking. So this in this domain hijacking, this is also known as domain theft. So the attacker may get the credentials of the domain register owner, and it can then hijack its domain, and it can change, and he can change the association of this domain and associate the domain with its own website. So this attack can perform by stealing the credential of actual domain owner or domain admin, or also by performing cross-site request forgery, or by performing man-in-the-middle attack. Now there is another method which is not illegal, but it is unethical. It is that once the domain registration of actual domain owner expires, then the attacker get the registration of this domain on its own for its own website, and it can and he can host the rogue website. So this is not illegal, but it is unethical, and it happens due to the you can say that if you due to the lack of due diligence by the domain owner. Now there are certain countermeasures against all of these attacks, and the first countermeasure is that you harden all the components of domain name system, and these components include your laptop or your DNS server or maybe your DHCP server. So you harden all these systems by removing unnecessary services from these components. And another countermeasure is that you block inbound traffic on port TCP 53 and UDP port 53. So TCP 53 is used to get the zone file from internal zone server by external zone server. So you limit this the transfer of internal zone files to external zone server. So in this case, the attacker, if he wants to get your zone data, he cannot get it. And UDP port 53 is used for DNS queries. So you also block the inbound traffic on UDP port 53 by external network. So no one from external network can get the information about your domain. Another countermeasure is that you also block the external internal queries to external DNS servers. So any rogue DNS server which is acting externally to your network cannot respond with malicious data to your internal clients. So your internal clients are unable to send DNS queries to external DNS server, and these clients can only send DNS queries to internal server. So you block UDP port 53 towards external networks. Another countermeasure is that you limit the external DNS server. So you only fetch the zone files from limited and trusted external DNS servers. Another countermeasure is that you use the DNS security or DNSSEC. So this DNSSEC is a security extension to main DNS, and it only provides authentication through digital certificates. So this DNSSEC does not provide encryption or confidentiality. It just provides authentication by using digital certificate. So the responses from or the queries to DNS server, the responses are authenticated using the digital certificate of DNS servers. So in this case, the rogue DNS server cannot send you the false data, since it does not have the digital certificate, as these are with the actual DNS server. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected for similar videos. Thank you.